module, actually, we started mechanical practices. For that also, we have started with burns and grass waterways. So what exactly we are doing actually here, we are reducing the total slope length in a by constructing various burns, or you can say terraces, so that the effective length of the length of slope can be reduced, and we can reduce the or we can prevent the soil erosion. So all the engineering measures that we are looking here are actually have some common objective. For example, all of these are, for example, if you are constructing burns or constructing terraces or you are using the grass waterways, all of these things are actually they tend to increase the infiltration opportunity time compared to the no bunding or no terrace operation. So we want to increase the infiltration opportunity time so that water will get more amount of time to infiltrate into the soil, and soil moisture level below the soil surface can be increased. So that is one objective. Another objective we have looked into, that is actually we are reducing the bad effect of high slope. So we are dividing the entire slope into smaller segments. And in a smaller segment, we are checking that whatever soil is being transported, so that soil will not get displaced or will not be eroded to a larger distance. They will be retained within the within those burns or within those terraces. Okay. And in a way, and at the end, after following this objective, we will tend to conserve more amount of soil. So we tend to prevent the soil erosion. So before that, we have looked into grass waterways, then burns we have looked into, and very briefly, yesterday's class, we have looked into what is mean by terraces. Okay. So what effectively here we are doing, actually, we are reducing this bigger length into smaller length, so that we can check the high erosive, we can prevent the erosion by reducing the, or by regulating the flow that is happening along this slope. Then we have seen what we are doing. Actually, we are effectively reducing, we are backing up the rate of water descent, so that water will get more time to retain in that soil. So the velocity of the water, running water, will be slowed down, and soil loss can be prevented. So why it is important? Because soil loss, main paper have found that, many researchers have found that soil loss is directly proportional to the square root of land slope. So if you are working, or if you are tend to reduce the length of slope, or if you are shortening the length of slope, then the runoff velocity can be reduced by that, and because of that, as a result of that, soil erosion can be prevented. Soil erosion because of the scouring of runoff water, so that can be prevented. And then we have seen what are the various functions of terrace actually we are trying to achieve. So very first function is actually that we want to reduce the erosion. We want to control the soil erosion that is happening on a slopey terrain. And we also, depending on the situation of the climate or availability of water, whether we want to conserve moisture or not, that is also up to us. So the second function that is actually meant from the terrace is actually to conserve moisture. Third is actually to reduce the floods, because we are regulating the flow. So we are increasing the time of concentration, and in a way, controlling the how the flow should take place over an area. And also by regulating this kind of flow, we tend to restrict the process of formation of gullies. So gully formation can be prevented by allowing water to flow in a regulated and controlled manner by the application of terraces. And more or less having terrace in a this kind of terrain is actually a good, will overall leads to a healthy ecosystem. Okay, so vegetation plantation, if you are doing some vegetation plantation along with this terracing, then overall it will have a good effect on the slopey terrain, because of this vegetation will have less amount of splash erosion, because most of the water will be rainwater, instead of directly hitting to the soil surface, it will first hit to the canopy. Okay, so splash erosion can be avoided, and also because the roots of this plant tend to bind the soil particle together, that's why the soil particle will have less erodibility. So our soil will have less erodibility, and also because of this terracing, will tend to retain more amount of water, and because of the presence of vegetation as well, there will be more amount of infiltration and more amount of water will be retained within that location as opposed to the what is happening in the bare soil condition. So as I said, it is actually overall is having a good effect on ecosystem because of this carbon, because of this thing, because of the enhanced infiltration, reduced soil erosion, and increased carbon sequestration. And then we have seen what are the limitations where it cannot be used. For example, it cannot be used in a regions which are actually having too much sandy soil, because sandy soils are actually kind of loose soil. So the cohesiveness or cohesive properties of sandy soil is less. So even if you form a bund, then it will have very less amount of strength. Okay. So terraces are practically less important when the sand content is more, or also when there is a more amount of stone are present in the soil, then also it is not desirable. We can construct it, but the overall we'll have to have more amount of maintenance, and lot of running cost will be high. So that's why it is not feasible in a terrain which are having stony condition and sandy soil. Also, where the soil is shallow, means the upper layer, the soil is very shallow, over that case also, the terracing is actually not very economical. Okay. Also, it is not advisable on a land that are having very irregular slope or very high slope, very slight slope. So in all these cases, terracing is not desirable, because it will cost a lot of money, because a lot of maintenance activity will be required, and overall a benefit that we are going to receive from it actually will not be sufficient. So that's why over these kinds of region, terracing is not profitable. Okay. Then we have seen the classifications, the broader classification of terraces. So terraces can be broadly divided into two types: broad-based terrace, bench terrace. The purpose of these two things are different. So broad-based are basically meant for or a land which are having tend to have flatter slope, and where farming activity farming equipment to easily pass through ridge. Okay, and where our basic purpose or basic objective is to either remove the excess water or to retain the water. On the other hand, bench terraces, we are creating a bench on a bench kind of a flat or sloping bench on a terrain, so that we can do cropping over that, and we can reduce the effect of land slope, bad effect of land slope, by constructing that kind of benches along the slope, across the slope. Okay, so broad terraces can be further divided into two types: graded, means we are providing some grade to it along its length, so that excess water can be easily disposed at non-erosive velocity. Non-erosive velocity means the velocity which will not cause any damage to the geometry of the terrace, as well as the soil loss will be less. Okay, so grades can be provided. So this grade can be a proper channel or improper channel. So graded broader broad based terrace, that is one type. Another is actually level, where we are not providing grade. So that is actually level along its length. So that is actually second category. On the other hand, bench terraces can be classified into four categories. First is actually the level and tabletop, where actually the bench, the stepless structure that we are creating, is actually horizontal. Kind of level and horizontal, or it can be a sloping outward. The slope of the bench that we are constructing across the slope, perpendicular to slope, actually that we are creating that can be sloping outward. We can provide some slope that is having outward slope to that bench, or that slope of the bench can be also inward, so that is sloping inward. And the fourth category is a kind of different one, that is a Puerto Rican or California type bench terrace, which actually takes a lot of time to form. There are various stages and series of operations have to be done to achieve a good Puerto Rican kind of terrace, bench terrace. So we have seen the graded terrace and what is meant by graded terrace and level terrace. So graded terrace are desired. So graded means we are providing some grade to the broader base terrace. So why grade is provided? Because we want to remove the excess water. Why we want to remove excess water? Because we don't want a waterlogging kind of condition place for that region. So that's why we are providing some grade. Okay, and yes, we are providing grade. So it means it has to be on an area which is receiving high amount of rainfall. So rainfall should be higher. For example, greater than 600 mm rainfall is there, then in those regions we can construct this graded terrace. Okay, and the grade that we are providing to this terrace, grade we are providing along the length. So grade that we are providing along the length can be a uniform grade, or it can be divided into multiple segments. So first quarter different grades, next quarter different grade, next quarter different grade, and last quarter different grade. So variable grade can be provided to the terrace length, along the terrace length, or it can be a variable uniform grade or variable grade. Okay, so that is actually graded terrace, which has main purpose to control water logging and to dispose excess water without causing damage to the terrace structure and without causing soil erosion. Level terrace, on the other hand, is having no slope along its length. Okay, so along the length of the terrace, the slope is kind of level. So that is actually level terrace. So the classification of level terrace are based on the width of the ridge. If the width is wide, then we can call it as a wide-based, level terrace. Or if it is narrow, then we can call it as a narrow-based means base is actually here, the base of the width of this ridge or channel. So if the width of this ridge is smaller, for example, 1.2 to within 2.5 meter, then we can call it as a narrow-based terrace. And these kinds of terrace are actually popular in some part of India. Narrow-based terrace are popular in some part of India. Okay. So this diagram that we have briefly seen. So what it shows actually, the original slope is like this. So whatever this dotted line is showing, this line is showing actually the original land slope. We have to construct some ridge, and we have to construct this terrace. So this example is for broad based terrace. So we are excavating this soil. We are cutting this portion with some cross section. We will see what should be the dimension in the designing part. Okay, so this soil has been excavated, and the same soil is being used to form a ridge. Ridge means this kind of like embankment, earth embankment. So this is actually a ridge. Okay, so this ridge is prepared using the same amount of same volume of soil that has been excavated from upslope. So the water is running in this direction. Okay, so and it is prevented by this ridge. Okay, so these are different terms actually. So this is actually the channel back. So this is actually your land slope. This is actually your this is the cut. This is fill portion. This is a front slope. This is back slope. And suppose we have seen in most of the design, we have to provide some freeboard to account for excess water, or to prevent the overflow. So that is a freeboard, and this is actually your design channel depth. So this is actually your design channel depth. This is channel back slope. This is a width of cut, width of fill width, and this is a back width. So likewise, there are different terms that we are going to see. So this is for triangular design, and this is for like trapezoidal design. So this is ridge, and on the ridge also we can have some width. So this is ridge width. Then we have seen what is mean by graded channel type terrace. Graded channel means we are providing some grade to across the terrace length so that excess water can be driven out of the channel in a non-erosive velocity. Okay, so we are excavating this this soil from here, and we are putting it here, and water is allowed to flow along the length. Along the length, water it can be disposed of either in a vegetative waterways or on using proper gully control structure, or wherever you want to dispose, but it should be done properly. So this is actually the cut that we are doing, and this is a fill. So here actually erosion is controlled. Here the erosion is controlled by reducing the slope length, and we are conducting this intercepted runoff, because here suppose on Austrian side the runoff will be collected, here the runoff will be collected, so that runoff intercepted, and it will be conducted to a safe outlet. So for example, at some distance along its length we have provided some outlet, there it can be disposed safely at non-erosive velocity. Normally this type of terrace are constructed by cutting a shallow channel. So these are actually shallow channel on the uphill side, and using only this soil to build an embankment. So only whatever volume of soil that has been here, that is actually we are filling it here to make the embankment. Okay, so if the slope is more, for example greater than 8%, we can put some grass on the back slope so that it can a more stable structure. Okay, so this grass back slope may be 2:1, on this slope we can put some grass. So this is a graded or channel type terrace. Next is level. So level means we are not providing a slope or grade along the terrace length. So primary function here is actually to retain the moisture, so because we don't want to dispose excess water, so we want to retain the water. So that's why we are not providing the grade here. So this kind of broad-based terrace, a broad-based level or ridge type of terrace, are actually suitable for a region which are receiving a low to moderate amount of rainfall. In the previous case, we are receiving high amount of rainfall. That's why we want to dispose excess water. But here, we want to retain the water so that water will get more time to infiltrate into the soil, and the soil moisture content in the top layer can be increased. So that is the purpose in the level and ridge type of terrace. So this is one example of broad base flat or level channel terrace. So here actually you can see, so this is actually one ridge to ridge. This is actually farmable interval, and this is actually the terrace spacing, horizontal interval, and various terms. So you can see, since it's a broader base, it means the farming equipment can easily pass through these ridges. So they are kind of flatter in shape. So whatever embankment that we are using here are usually constructed of soil taken on the both side of the ridge. Okay, so from both side of the ridge, we can take this soil and we can make this embankment here. So it is necessary to obtain sufficient high embankment to prevent overtopping. So our purpose here is to conserve moisture. So since we are not disposing the water, we are not providing any grade along the length of the terrace. So the embankment should be strong and stable, and we have to prevent the overtopping of this. Overtopping means overflow of this water on the top of this embankment. So that should be prevented. So overtopping should be prevented, and breaking through also should be prevented. Okay, so it should be a stable, a proper compaction should be done so that it should not break easily. Okay, so that was actually broad based terrace. Now our next broad based terrace was having objective either to dispose the excess water or to retain the water. So if you want to dispose the water, we have to use the graded terrace, and if you want to retain the water, we have to use level terrace. So both of these cases we have seen in the last few slides. Now next part is actually bench terrace, which is more popular, where actually we are creating a bench. So bench is nothing but a flat surface. It can be either level or it can be either sloping outward or inward. That we'll see in the subsequent slide. So bench is actually consist of series of flat shelf like areas that convert a steep slope of 20 to 30% to a series of level or nearly level benches. So for example, so this is actually the original slope of this land. So original slope of this land is actually very steep, and no kind of agricultural activities are possible here. Forget about the agricultural activity, but this kind of slope, if there is a soil on this here on the surface, then the chances of soil erosion is also very high. So by constructing this bench kind of structure here, so this is a bench. Okay, so this is a terrain bench that can be constructed so that runoff water can be trapped, and this bench can be used for cultivation purpose. Okay, so this is actually the bench that we are constructing here. So we are modifying this whatever slope, original land slope was there, by constructing this kind of bench. So right now these benches are actually flat, so this is known as flat bench terrace. Okay, on the top of it is actually on the extreme side there is small shoulder bund is provided. So this bund is known as shoulder bund. So this is actually the shoulder bund. The purpose of shoulder bund is actually to provide stability and also to retain water and prevent the overtopping or breaking through of this, or to prevent overtopping or breaking through this terrace. So that's the purpose of shoulder bund. Sometimes this, okay, so right now we have provided some slope here, or we can go just like this as well. Some step like structure where this is actually straight vertical distance. Okay, so here the slope is actually, so this is actually 0:1 means. Okay, or we can give some slope, we can give 1:1 slope. We can give 1:1 slope or 0.5:1, whichever is suitable, that we'll see when to use what kind of slope. Okay, so using this bench terrace, we can shorten the length of runoff water flow, so that we can prevent the soil erosion. So you can see there is a lot of precision is required, and a lot of earthwork is also required. So these kinds of terraces should be used in an area where we want to do agriculture and there is no other agricultural land which is available, and we have only one option than to convert this slopy terrain into agriculture land. So in those cases we can construct these terraces. And important thing here to note here, actually these dimensions are actually has to be done properly, otherwise it will not serve the actual purpose. So dimension is taken care, it should be done properly, it should be designed properly, and also it should be implemented properly. So there is a lot of cost involved. Okay, so the basic thing is actually we are doing it only when there is no other alternative. This is another special type of bench terrace, that is actually conservation bench, where we have multiple objective from that land. So we can use combination of conservation practices to achieve maximum benefit of it. So we are not just going with the bench terraces, but we are going along with the bench terrace, we are going with other practices as well. So this conservation practices, conservation bench terrace adaptable to slope up to 6 to 8%, which is suitable in semi-arid regions where maximum moisture content is needed. Okay, so what we are doing here is actually, this kinds of conservation bench terrace consist of an earthen embankment and a very broad and nearly flat. So very broad and nearly flat channel that resembles like a level bench. Okay, So this will serve as a purpose of storage area, and this will be the upslope area that is actually contributing to runoff to this storage area. Okay, so this, now next is the classification of bench terrace. So bench terrace can be classified into broadly classified into four types. Bench terrace with level top, so this is a level top. So the bench is not having any slope with the horizontal, so you can say this is a level bench or table top slope. Okay, so what we have done, so this is actually the cut material, and this is actually the fill material. So we have excavated this portion and we have filled this one, excavated this one and filled it here. Okay, so this is the first type, level top or flat bench terrace. Sometimes if you are having irrigation practices here, irrigation water is available, then we can call it as irrigated bench terrace. That's the first type. Second type is actually if this slope of this bench, so this is actually your bench. So this is bench. If this bench is flat, it is level bench terrace. If it is making slope outward, so right now, let's say this is actually this is a bench. So it is making some angle. So it is not horizontal. So it is having slope in outward direction. Okay, so it's actually outward sloping bench terrace, and this is inward bench. Okay, so the slope is inward here, so that is actually your inward sloping bench terrace. So in all these cases, this was the original slope, and now by constructing this bench terrace, the terrain will look like this. So this is level terrace, this is actually your outward sloping bench terrace. So you can see by constructing these kinds of bench terrace, we have reduced the slope so that the soil erosion can be prevented. And this is the third type, and the fourth type is Puertorican, where actually we are constructing this bench terrace. There are various stages are there. Actually, first we'll excavate some soil here and we can put some vegetative barrier. After some duration, this will become mature, and this will, after some time, it will look like this. So these are actually naturally constructed bench terrace. It takes a lot of time. So that is actually your Puertorican type. Sometimes it is referred to as California type bench terrace. Okay, let's see this thing in detail. So yesterday we have not seen this one. So this is actually the level top. So level top means here the terrace is actually the flat. So this is actually a flat bench terrace, or sometimes it is referred to as level top bench terrace. So let's see what are the different components here that are given here. So this was the original slope. Original slope is denoted by this dashed line. So this was the original land slope. And now we have constructed this terrace here, which is flat. Okay, this portion represents the cut. So here we have excavated the soil and we have put it here. This is also represent the excavation, the cut, and we have put it here. We have made it here. And at the top of it, actually, we have put some shoulder bund to prevent overtopping and to provide stability. Okay, Now let's see what are different terms that are given here. So we can see this is W. W is actually the width of terrace. Okay, so W denotes the width of terrace. So from this point to this point, this denotes width of the terrace. Okay, total horizontal spacing, horizontal distance of terrace, which is given by, let's say, L. Let's say we call it as, sometime it is referred called by L. So L is equal to D by 2 plus W plus D by 2. So L is equal to D plus W. Okay. So here actually it is D by 2. Why it is D by 2? Because we are going with this batter. So sometimes it is called as riser, sometimes it is referred to as batter. So both are same thing, riser or batter. So riser slope or batter slope is 1:1. So it means here it is D by 2, here also it is D by 2. Okay, so that's why this D by 2 is there. So depending on whatever slope is given, these value will vary. So you have to change this value. If it is 1:2:1, then it will become D by 4. Okay, so accordingly you have to change this one. So total this spacing, horizontal spacing, is actually this whole distance. The vertical interval is actually denoted by either VI or D. Okay, so from the base of this one to the base of the upstream terrace, that is actually your vertical interval. This is actually your vertical interval, and sometimes it's denoted by either D or VI. So these things you should remember. So if it is asked in the question to calculate the area, earthwork area, then you have to use this formula. This formulas are very simple, but you should know what is mean by vertical interval, what is mean by width, and what is mean by depth of flow, what is mean by freeboard. All these terms should be known to you. So you can choose, means you can solve the problem very easily. So right now, as we are discussing the level top, bench terrace, so these are actually suitable in a region which are receiving medium rainfall, which is actually medium rainfall, medium annual rainfall, and the areas that are having evenly distributed and deep permeable soil. So here our main purpose is to retain water and to go with some kind of ponding depth. For example, if you want to do cultivation, for example, paddy crop. So paddy means rice. So paddy crop requires like ponding water. So in those cases, we can go with this one. So we don't want to dispose excess water. So that's why we are not providing. So this is actually a like level terrace where we want to retain moisture so that maximum water can be retained into the soil and can be allowed to infiltrate into the soil. So these are actually suitable in medium rainfall area which are evenly distributed and deep permeable soil. So whether to dispose or whether to store this water, that depends on what kind of slope that we are providing along the land. So right now we are talking about the slope of this. Right now the slope is flat. Okay, so we can provide some grade along the length as well. So that we'll see later, or we have seen in case of broader base terrace along the length. So that is different slope. Here it is flatter. So that's why it is called level top terrace. So these types of terrace are constructed exactly on the contours and provided with sufficient freeboard so that they can trap most of the rainfall that falls. So we are providing some excess freeboards. Whatever the design depth is there, on the top of it we are keeping some freeboard so that we can trap most of the rainfall or high intensity rainfall or extreme rainfall that is happening without causing a damage or without causing overflow. Okay. So sometimes it is used in regions where irrigation water is available, so then in that case it is referred to as irrigated bench terrace. So that is actually first type. Second, now it is outward sloping. So you can see earlier case, it was a flatter. the bench was flatter slope. Now there is a outward slope. So here also, this dotted line denotes the original slope. So we have modified this terrain and we have made this bench terrace, which are actually sloping outward. So there is a slight slope here that you can see. So there is a slight slope, so that's why it is called as outwards sloping terrace. So here also, this represents the cut portion. This is actually your fill. This is also cut portion, and this is actually your fill. This is also again your cut portion. Okay. So here actually we can give outward slope up to 10%, and these are the standard dimension that are given of the shoulder bund. So shoulder bund can be constructed, which is of base 120 centimeter in width, base width. Top width can be thought of 30 centimeter, and like the height of this shoulder bund can be around 45 centimeter. So we are talking about this bund. Okay, so height is 45 centimeter, top width is 30 centimeter. Like base width is 120 centimeters. So that is actually your shoulder bund. So in case of this outward sloping bench terrace, the provision of shoulder bund is actually very much important. Because why it is important? Because we are providing an outward slope. So we don't want water to flow easily. We don't want water to run down from this bench easily. So that's why we are providing this shoulder bund. So the provision of the shoulder bunds is very much important in outward bund than compared to other two types, the level top and the inward sloping. Okay. These types of terrace are suitable for orchards. So excess water, what will happen to the excess water? Sometimes some channel at the lower end, some channels are provided to dispose the excess water. Okay, so that is actually a second type, that is outward sloping. Now the next type is inward sloping. So this is inward sloping. So here you can see, so in previous case the slope was outward, so here the slope is inward. So you can see we have constructed this terrace. So we can see, as you can see here, the slope is inwards. An inward slope of up to 8.667% is provided here. And this is again, so this was the original slope and now it is reduced like this. So this is actually your cut portion. So this soil is excavated from here and filled here. So this is also your cut portion, and the soil is being filled here. As you can see here, we have provided some shallow channel here. So since we are providing an inward slope, that's why we are also providing some shallow channels, so that excess water can be drained easily along the length. So it means this channel will either run in this direction or in this direction, depending on whichever direction we are providing the exit. Okay. So excess water can be disposed from it. Okay. So these kinds of terrace are effective in a heavy rainfall area. So we are heavy, and the soils which are having highly permeable. If the soils are highly permeable and heavy rainfall area, so in those cases we can go with these kinds of inward sloping terrace. Okay. So since actually we are allowing more water to return here, so only those crops we can take that can sustain an excess water or water logging condition. Only those crops can be taken in this inward sloping terrace. So that was the third type of bench terrace. So this is actually the direction of water movement that is shown in this pictorial form in level terrace. So there is no so this is actually flat. So this is actually your runoff water. Whatever rainfall is falling, it will be collected here, and it can either infiltrate here, and depending on the channel, it can drain. Depending on the grade, this grade, this can either dispose out of the system or it can be retained here. This is the sloping outward, so you can see there is a slope outward, and this is sloping inward. So here you can see the slope is inward, and here you can see this this channel is provided, so the excess water can be drained like this. Yeah, looking at if you look at this figure, these are also show some of the components. So you can see this is a level top, typical level top bench terrace. So you can see this is actually your bench. This is actually your shoulder bund. So you can see here, either we can have this vertical, riser, or it can be inclined. Okay. So in previous case, we have seen the inclined case, 1:1 or 1/2:1. Okay. So in vertical case, this is a vertical case. Now see different components here. So total width of terrace means from this point to this point, this denotes the total width of terrace. Vertical interval means the height of this terrace, vertical interval, that is actually vertical interval, and depth of cut is actually, this is actually a depth of cut. Okay, so this is actually a triangle. This top portion actually we are excavating, the soil is excavated from this triangular portion. So the height of that actually denotes the depth of cut, and vertical interval is actually twice of this one. So vertical interval is actually twice of depth of cut in case of in this case. Okay, any questions so far?
No sir.
Okay, so these are few more diagrams that shows the different types of terrace. So there are a few more types that we will not discuss in this course, but there are for example this half moon terrace, there are actually meant for planting trees and orchards kind of thing, that will not discuss in this course. But if you want to study in more detail, you can visit this paper by Chen et al. 2020 paper, very recent paper. There actually they have mentioned the performance of different terrace. Or you can do the assignment that I have given to you, in which the last assignment is related with the biological measures to control, non-biological measures to control the soil erosion. So in that actually, that group can discuss, that group can take this paper to discuss their work. Okay, one case study. This paper can be selected as one of the case study where they have compared the performance of different bench terraces. On whether they are able to retain the good amount of moisture, or which combination is giving high amount of soil erosion, or which are high amount of soil moisture and less amount of soil erosion. So they can use this paper, or you can choose any of the paper that whichever you find comfortable with. Okay. Now coming to the design of terrace system. So design of terrace system depends on like governed by the what kind of study area we have, what kind of soils we have, what is the soil characteristics, whether the soil is having high amount of sand content, silt content, clay content, what kind of soil we have. So first thing is actually the soil characteristics, whether the soil is permeable, what is the depth of the soil, all these things are actually important. Next, the climate. The climate means what kind of rainfall we have, temperature we have. So because of the rainfall and temperature condition, so because of the rainfall, we'll have the more amount of water, but if the temperature is more, there will be more evaporation. So climatic conditions are also important before selecting any type of terraces. Then what kind of cropping we are intend to do over that region, and what kind of soil management practices that are being that will be followed, that should be considered before designing a terrace. Okay. So the design of terrace system includes what kind of, based on this combination, what kind of bench terrace that we are selecting. Then what should be an adequate spacing between the two terrace, and what should be an ideal location from where to start exactly. We cannot just start from anywhere. So what should be an exact position from where we can start? Then design of the channel with adequate capacity. So whatever capacity for which we are designing, actually, so that capacity has to be considered. So we have seen how to, in previous, in case of grass waterways also, we have seen how to estimate the discharge capacity. So using a rational formula, we can calculate the design capacity, discharge capacity. Then depth of cut, how much soil has to be excavated, how much depth of soil has to be excavated. Then what should be the width of the terrace, and what should be the appropriate cross section of the terrace. All these things are actually are part of the designing of the terrace system. Okay, so while designing the terrace, what kind of data will be required to select what kind of terrace is required? So first is actually the rainfall, average annual rainfall. So if you go to any region, for example, if you go to Meghalaya region, or if you go to some region in central, or some region in like Maharashtra, where actually the rainfall is comparatively lesser as compared to the Meghalaya, then depending on that also, we can choose how much amount of rainfall is actually expected over that region. So that data will be required. So average annual rainfall, that is the first variable that we are going to need. Second is what kind of soil we have, whether the soil is having whether the soil is permeable or impermeable, what is the depth of the soil, what kind of soil we have, whether it is sandy soil, whether the silt content is more, clay content is more, all these things are very important. The second important variable or data required for designing is actually soil type and the depth of the soil. Then the third is the slope of the area. So so on which slope we intend to construct terrace. Okay, so that is also important. So it should not be too steep. Okay, so the average slope of the area, that is the third data that is required, and the crop and the soil management. What kind of cropping is intended, and the soil management practices that should be considered. So these are actually various data that should be required before designing the terraces. Okay, now first important variable of designing a terrace system is actually the spacing of the terrace. So spacing in horizontal direction and spacing in vertical direction. So in horizontal direction, we call it as horizontal spacing. In vertical, we call this a vertical interval or vertical spacing. Okay, now width. Width of the terrace. So you can, in this diagram, you can see the width of the terrace that is denoted by W. So here again, this is actually your original slope. This is the original land slope, and this is actually your level top terrace that we have constructed. We have excavated this soil here. So this is actually your cut portion, and this is actually your fill portion. So at finally, the shape of your bench terrace will be like this. Okay, obviously you can provide some shoulder bund here and some kind of channel, but just for explanation, I'm not mentioning here. But that we can assume that we are always providing some shoulder bund here. Okay, so width is actually, this is your width that is denoted by W. Okay, so that is approximate in case of this vertical drop and level top, it is actually half of width is this much, and this is half of width. Vertical interval sometimes denoted by VI, sometimes it is denoted by D. So that is actually your vertical interval. So this is actually your vertical interval that can be denoted by D. So this portion obviously it will be D by 2. Okay, and the slope of this land is S percent. So means for 100 meter, for 100 unit of horizontal distance, we have S meter, S unit of vertical drop. So S percent is the slope. S per, that is the original slope of the land. Okay. So as we can see, the width of the bench terrace should be based on the requirement. What we are going to see means, so this width depends on the soil characteristics as well as this width depends on the soil characteristic, because the wide benches required deep soils and high construction cost. So higher the width, more will be the cost. So that's why we have to choose what purpose we are going to use it, what kind of crop we are going to take it here, and what, depending on what kind of soil we have, based on that width can be decided. So for manual cultivation, normal width can be 2.5 to 5 meter, because in this actually we are not intended to do any farming machinery. But if you want to have provision for farming machinery, then in that case we can have a broader terrace. So that's why, that's the purpose of, we have seen the broader base terrace. In that case, width can be 3.5 to 8 meter for mechanized cultivation. Okay. So once this width is decided, so that is actually one part of the cross section. So once the width of the bench terrace is decided, we can, using this actually, we can estimate the, we can calculate the depth of cut, that is actually your half of the vertical interval, that is D by 2. It can be calculated. So using W, we can calculate the depth of cut. So this is actually your depth of cut. Depth of cut, that is actually half of your vertical interval. Okay. Now vertical interval or vertical spacing is actually given by this empirical equation. It can be calculated as a can be calculated as Vi is equal to 0.3 xs plus s, where s is actually your slope of that land in percentage. Okay, and x and y are actually some constants that are actually related with the x is for constant for geographic location, which is having range of 0.4 to 0.8, and y is actually a constant for that denotes the soil erodibility and cover condition during the critical erosion period. So if the soil is good and it is having a good cover, then y can be thought of 4. Or if the intake capacity of the soil is less and the crop cover is also not good, then we can have y is equal to 1. Okay. Or in other case, when one of the condition is favorable, for example, the infiltration intake capacity is good, but other one is not good, means the crop cover is not good, then we can think of y is equal to 2.5. Or vice versa. For example, if this, if the crop cover is not, if crop cover is good, but the intake rates are less. Okay, it's, I'm just hypothetical here. I'm just saying. But then y is equal to 2.5. So using that, we can estimate the VI. So we can say VI is like, or vertical interval is a function of S, that is actually land slope. Okay, so using that also, we can calculate the horizontal interval. Okay, now let's see the vertical interval based on slope for different types of batter slope. So batter means this riser slope. So this is a vertical riser. So there is no slope, no riser slope. So riser slope is kind of zero here. Okay, so in this case, so we can write this kind of equation. We can compare these two triangles. So we can say D by 2 divided by this W by 2. So just focus on these two triangles right now. ABC and this one. NMA. Okay. So these two triangles are equivalent, kind of equivalent. So we can say this D by 2 divided by this. So this this distance is half of the width. D by 2 divided by W by 2 will be equal to S divided by 100, because the slope of this terrain is S percent. Okay, so for 100 unit of horizontal distance, we have S vertical. Okay, so we can write this D by 2 divided by W by 2 is equal to S by 100, or we can write in another way, D is equal to WS by 100, where S is actually your slope in percentage. Okay, so in and W is actually your width of terrace. So width normally assumed as 4.5 meters for the slope is between 15 to 25% slope. And if the slope is even higher, for example, 25 to 33% slope, then we can have an even broader width of the terrace. Then it can be up to 3 meters. Okay, so this is your vertical interval. That is actually your D. And this is equation when the better slope is zero. So this is actually a condition when better slope is zero. This is a condition in which better slope is zero. Okay, so when this kind of slope is required, when the better slope is zero is required, or vertical riser is required, or it is used when the soil is more stable and depth of cut is small. The depth of cut, that is D by 2, is the smaller, or when the soil is more stable, then also we can go with this vertical riser. Otherwise, we have to give some slope to this riser as well. Okay, so this is actually a second case. In the second case, you can see now the better slope is 1:1. 1:1 means, so in previous case, I am comparing with respect to previous case. In previous case, it was a vertical. Okay, so in previous case, this better slope was zero. So it was vertical, but right now it is like this, 1:1 slope. Okay, so right now this will look like this. So we can say this riser slope is now 1:1. So 1:1 here. So if this is depth of cut, that is D by 2, then this will also become D by 2 distance. Okay. So in that case, we can use same formula again. We can again compare these two triangles. Triangle ABC and triangle NMA here. So here D by 2 divided by this distance divided by BC. So we can say AB divided by BC can be equal to NM divided by MA. Okay, so here AB is D by 2. AB is D by 2, and BC is actually can be thought of to this one actually. So it can be written as D by 2 plus, this is actually, so now it will be W by 2, this will be W by 2, or you can see this figure. Yeah, this figure is more clear here. Okay. So here you can see, yeah, if you start from here, so the slope of this soil is S by 100, that is S percent, and this is actually your terrace. Okay. Now we can see, you can compare these two triangles. So D by 2 or you can say this d by 2. So this is also this d by 2. So this is actually your d by 2 plus w by 2. So d by 2 plus w by 2, that is actually your total width till this point. So d by 2 divided by d by 2 plus w by 2 can be written as s by 100. So s by 100 will be equivalent to d by 2 divided by this distance. So d by 2 divided by d by 2 plus w by 2. So rearranging this equation, we can write d is equal to ws upon 100 minus s. Okay, so that is actually a case when batter slope is 1:1. So this is actually your riser or batter which is having 1:1 slope. Or you can, if you want to see it here, we can have this triangle. So here s by 100 is equal to your d by 2 by d by 2 plus w by 2, like that. Okay. Next is the case when the batter slope is 1:2. So in previous case it was 1:1. Now it is 1:2. So again, so now in here, now it is, since it is 1:2, this will become d by 4. Okay, this will be your w by 2. Okay, so here you can write d by 2 again, d by 2 divided by d by 4 plus w by 2 is equal to s by 100. And then vertical interval in this case will be d is equal to, if you rearrange this term, it will be d is equal to 2ws divided by 200 minus s. Okay, so a straightforward equation. So we have seen three cases. In first case, when the batter slope, when the riser was vertical, then it was simply d is equal to ws by 100. In next case, when batter slope was 1:1, when batter slope was 1:1, so this is 1:1, then it was d is equal to ws upon 100 minus s. And in the next case, when it is 1:1, then d is equal to 2ws upon 200 minus s. Okay, so these kinds of this slope is used to 1:1 riser slope is used. So this is actually a riser, that is actually a batter slope, is used when the soil is loose and less stable. In those cases, we can use this 1:2 riser slope. Okay. Yeah, so this is the fourth general case. So this is a general case in which batter slope, let's say batter slope is given in the form of SR, any slope, then we can calculate d is equal to ws upon 100 minus s into SR, where s is actually your land slope, that's actually your land slope, and SR is actually your slope of the riser. So the slope of this riser is actually your SR. and the slope of this land is actually your S percent. So now when we are done with the bench terracing, we can calculate the volume of earthwork required. Volume of earthwork means how much portion we have to cut. Okay, so for example, before that, if this riser slope is flatter, then it means more area will be lost, because here more area will be lost in this slope. So our purpose is actually to reduce this slope in such a way that more amount of land can be utilized in a farming activity. Okay, now to calculate the volume of earthwork required in bench terrace, so for example, if this is our case, this is general case, in a level bench. So this is actually our level bench. Okay, so in this actually we have to excavate this soil. So we have to excavate this portion. Okay, so this portion has to be excavated. So the cut volume of earth can be calculated as a half area of this triangle. That is actually half base. That is actually half into base. That is actually W by 2 into height D by 2 and multiplied by the length of this terrace. Okay, so this is we are just seeing at the side view of this terrace. Okay, so this is actually our length. So multiply by the length will give the total volume of earthwork required. So it is given as volume of earthwork required. You can either use VI or D. So D into W into L by 8. So volume of earthwork required in bench terrace is given by this expression. Okay, so this I have explained for level bench top. In other case also you can calculate. So but in other case, for example, in sloping outward, you have to accommodate this as well. Okay, so here also you have to accommodate this as well. Okay, so here you have to so this is actually your d by 2 and this is actually your the w by 2 into g. Okay, then when we have calculated this volume of earthwork bench terrace, that is given by D W L by 8 or V I W L by 8. L K can be length of this length can be calculated like this. L is equal to 10,000 per hectare. This is actually 10,000 divided by W plus V I. We'll come to this when we are solving a problem. Okay, area of plantation root 2 DL or root 2 VI into L. Okay, then coming to the terrace grades means we are giving some grade or slope along the length. So in determining the grade, due consideration should be given to the factors such as the what kind of soil we have, the spacing of the terrace and length of the terrace. So grade should be sufficient to provide good drainage and develop adequate flow without scoring the channel and washing out the crop. So the grade should be such that it should not cause any damage to the crop. So there should be less amount of erosion. Erosion has to be prevented and it should not cause any mechanical damage to the growing crop that is grown on the bench. So if the grades are not sufficient, there can be chances of high water logging and the crops may be drowned, and the farm operation can also be difficult in those cases in case of waterlogged condition. Okay, so as we have discussed before, the grade that we are providing to this terrace, so the grade, channel grade that we are providing to this terrace, so grade that we are providing here, it can be either uniform grade or variable grade. Variable grade means we can divide it into multiple segment and we can provide different grades to it. And this is actually, it can be disposed to this vegetative waterway or some outlet that is there. So this is actually in like a graded case, but in when this grade is zero, then we call it as a level terrace. These grades can be of range of 0.1 to 0.6% depending on the soil type and climate factors. And generally, the steeper grades are recommended for impervious soil because in impervious soil, the chances of infiltration will be less. So what we can do, there is very, like we have to dispose that water because the infiltration will be very low because the soil is impervious, kind of impervious. So this American Society of Agriculture Engineers 1972, according to them, the recommended maximum velocity. So velocity means the channel velocity. So this velocity of water in case of erosive soil, it can be 0.46 meter per second. And if soil is more stable, less erosive, this flow with even higher velocity, that is around 0.61, provided that the roughness coefficient n is equal to 0.03. So the grade that we are providing can be uniform or it can be varied, that we have seen. Variable grade terrace is more effective because the capacity increases toward the outlet. So the capacity increases toward the outlet, correspondingly there will be increase in runoff toward the outlet. Okay, and there will be reduced amount of velocity in the portion. So there will be more chances of absorption and more amount of infiltration can be possible, but that can also leads to high amount of like sediment deposition. So proper grade has to be selected for different segments. So let's see a table that denotes the different example of different types of grade that can be thought of along the channel length. Okay, so depending on the terrace length, for example, the terrace length is 30 to 120 meter, then in the lower quarter, we can go with grade equal to 0.3%. Second quarter also, we can retain the same grade. Third quarter also, we can reduce it, and in the uppermost quarter the grade can be even less. For example, in case of 270 meter to 360 meter terrace, 260 meter to 370 meter terrace, we can go with lower grade is given to the upper portion from means from where the runoff is starting, and in the lower portion it can be given as a higher grade because we want to dispose the excess water. Then coming to the terrace length, the length of terrace is actually very important. So for safe output capacity, safe outlet capacity is an important factor in determining the terrace length. So the maximum length for graded terrace generally ranges from 300 to 500 meters. So we have seen different types of combination in the previous slide. So these are different combination, but ideally it can be around 300 to 500 meters depending on the size and shape of the field and what kind of runoff rate we are handling and what quantity of runoff we are handling and outlet possibility. Based on that, the length of the terrace can be decided. Okay, so in the case of level terrace, there is no maximum length provided that the blocks and dams are provided in the channel about 150 meters. So at every 150 meter length, we are providing some checks and dams so that water can be easily disposed to the downstream part. Okay, each 150 meters, so in that case there will be no restriction to the length. On permeable soil, longer terrace may be permitted than impervious soils, because in permeable soil, more amount of water will be infiltrated. So the running velocity or running water velocity will be smaller in case of permeable soil than in case of impervious soil. Okay, now coming to the cross section. So the cross section of this terrace is consist of different parts. So we have seen For example, let's say this we are talking about the outward sloping terrace. So let's say this is outward terrain. So so we have to consider various other parts as well. For example, what should be the dimension of shoulder bund? What should be the outward slope? Or in case of inward slope, what should be the inward slope? So this is actually your inward sloping terrace. Okay. So inward slope and outward slope, that should be considered. And the shoulder bund dimension should be considered. And of course, other parameters are also we have seen what is mean by spacing width, spacing, horizontal spacing and vertical interval, width of the terrace, all these things has to be considered. Okay. Now coming to the shoulder bund dimension, the shoulder bund means, for example, so this is actually your shoulder bund. Okay, so the shoulder bund dimension depends on the type of bench terrace. So in case of terrace sloping inwards, so this is actually a terrace sloping inwards, the size of the shoulder bund should be nominal, while in the terrace sloping outward, for example, if the terrace is sloping outward, terrace sloping outward, this shoulder bund is essential that we have seen in the previous slides. The cross section, it should be larger, it should be more stable and larger. Okay, when the this bench slope is facing outward, in that case is actually there should be stronger and it should able to hold whatever amount of rainfall that is happening and upstream. Okay, so these are general consideration. Top width can be thought of, for example, this is actually your bund. So top width can be thought of 30 centimeter, base width can be thought of 120 centimeter, and this height of the shoulder bund can be thought of 45 centimeter. So these are general recommendation that can be followed. Okay. Now in case of inward sloping and outward sloping, what should be the inward slope and outward slope? So inward slope and outward slope, that depends on the what kind of soil we have and what how much amount of rainfall we expect over that region. Okay, so inward slope varies from 2 to 10%, and outward slope varies from 2 to 8.5%. So inward sloping terrace, inward sloping terrace, we provide channel at the inner edge of the terrace. So we have seen in the previous slides where we are providing the for example, inward facing means so here actually we are providing some channel. This is actually inward slope. So inward sloping terrace, a drainage channel is provided at the inner edge of the terrace to dispose the excess water. So this water will be disposed along the length. Okay. The channel dimensions are calculated knowing the excess runoff magnitude and using the Manning's equation. So we have seen the excess runoff using the rational formula. And velocity V can be calculated using the Manning's formula. So we have seen what is mean by Manning's formula. Manning's formula is given by RS to 2 by 3, SS to 1 half divided by N. And Q is equal to CIA to determine the 36 to determine the peak discharge capacity. So this is actually for capacity, and this is actually the for erosive non-erosive velocity, calculation of non-erosive velocity. So here we are talking about channel dimension. So when you are talking about channel dimension, we are talking about the velocity of flow. So velocity of flow can be calculated by this Manning's equation, RS 2 by 3, SS 2 1 half upon N. Okay, and then Q is equal to A into V. Okay. So cross section of the terrace, so this is actually showing the various parameters related to the cross section. Most of the things we already seen. So this is actually your depth of cut, this is actually your depth of fill, this is actually your design depth, and this is actually your freeboard that is there at the top. Okay, so cut depth is denoted by C, fill depth is denoted by F, depth of flow is denoted by D, and this freeboard is denoted by FB or F. Sorry, F is denoted by fill, so this is actually your freeboard. H is actually your total depth, height of the bund. So H, height of bund, can be thought of H is equal to your D plus freeboard. And these are some slopes. So this is actually your original slope. So this dashed line shows the original slope that is shown in S, shown by S. This is actually the slope of this cut slope. This is actually your back slope. This is actually your front slope, which is denoted by WF. The same thing. So depth of flow, so this depth of flow, we have seen this H is equal to this depth of flow plus freeboard. Okay, so this depth of flow, that D, can be determined from runoff rate of 10-year return period storm, or for required runoff for storage terrace. Okay, so using that actually we can calculate the depth of flow, and when the side slopes are equal, when the side slopes are equal, then width, this WC, whatever we are talking about here, WC means width, cut width, and this is actually your front slope width, and this is actually your back width. Okay, so this can be when the side slopes are equal, means cut slope, front slope, when these are equal, then and back slope are equal, then we can think of as this is equal to W. Now from the geometry we can find this relation. So cut plus fill is equal to H plus S into W, where H is actually your total height of this total depth of the channel including the freeboard. S is actually your original land slope that is denoted by capital S in percentage, in fraction L by L, and W is actually your width of slope. Now this is actually showing various combination of fill slope and various combination of cut slope, front slope and back slope. Okay, so this is actually your cut slope, this is actually your front slope, this is actually your back slope. For different combination of S percentage, these are the values of cut slope, front slope and back slope. Now coming to the capacity, terrace channel capacity. So with the graded terrace, rate of runoff is more important. So what is important? Rate of runoff is more important than total runoff. Why rate is important? Because we don't want flow to pass through very quickly. Because if it pass very quickly, then it will cause more erosion. Okay, so we don't want that. That's why rate of runoff is more important than total amount of rainfall. Okay, so meter cube per second important than volume of runoff. Okay, while designing the design of level or conservation bench terrace, which is while in case of graded terrace, for example, if you are providing some grade to this terrace. For example, if you are providing some grade to this terrace, then in that case, this like rate of runoff is more important than volume. But in level terrace, means when there is a no slope along the length, then in that case, both this rate of runoff and the volume of runoff is important. Okay, so this we have seen the maximum design velocity that will vary depending on the soil type, but in any case, it should not cross more than 0.6 meter per second. If the velocity is more than 0.6 meter per second, it is not desirable and it will cause a lot of erosion. So your velocity in any case, it should be less than 0.6 meter per second. Okay. Then coming to the channel depth, the channel depth should permit approximately 20% of the freeboard, 20% of freeboard of the total depth. And the in case of gridded terrace, peak runoff rate can be calculated using 10 years of rainfall intensity storm. Then runoff volume of for level conservation bend terrace should be based on 10-year 24-hour duration storm. That we'll see in the example. Now let's calculate the area lost under bench terrace. Why area lost? Because we are constructing this batter. So we are constructing, we are giving some kind of slope to this riser. Okay. So this is actually, we are making it some kind of slope. So these risers are constructed with some slope. So that's why there will be some area will be lost. Okay. So some cultivated area will be lost because of the construction of a terrace. Then in problem, it may be like it is desirable before constructing terrace, how much area will be lost if we consider particular kind of riser, particular slope of riser. Okay, so all this calculation should be done before going to with the final design. Okay, so let's see one case when the batter slope is given as 1:1, but 1:1 means this is equal to this, is 1:1. So this batter slope is 1:1. Batter slope or riser slope, whatever you want to call it. So let D be the vertical interval. So for example, so this is actually your D. So this is actually your vertical interval, and half of this is actually your D/2. D/2 denotes the depth of cut. Denotes the vertical interval. Okay. So let D be the vertical interval of the bench that has to be laid out on a land that is having slope S%. So original slope of this land is actually your S%. Okay, and for this land, we are constructing this terrace with a vertical interval D and with batter slope 1:1. And in that case, L is actually your horizontal interval. So this is actually your horizontal interval. So what will be the value of L? Value of L will be here. L is equal to this D/2 because it is 1:1 slope. Plus W plus this D/2. So L is equal to D plus W when batter slope is equal to 1:1. Okay. Now, suppose if you are interested in calculating the area loss under bench terrace, then AB, let's see those calculation. So let's first calculate this length. So this is actually your A. Let's consider one point A, and this is actually your point. Okay, this is your point B, and this is actually your length AB. Okay, so this length AB can be we can write this expression AB is equal to this L square, because AB is equal to L square plus D square. Okay, and we can simplify like this. So we can write expand this series. So AB can be written as AB is equal to L plus D square by 2L, and we know that this L is L. You can say okay. So AB can be written as AB is equal to L plus D square by 2L, And we know that L, that is actually this length, can be so L can be written like this. L is equal to 100 d by s. So we have seen in case of calculation of this vertical interval. So s, so here let's say L is actually a horizontal interval, d is actually a vertical interval. So L can be written as L is equal to 100 d. L is equal to d by s, where s is equal to, s is in percent. That's why this 100 is coming here. Okay. So after substituting this L value of L here, this equation will become like this. AB is equal to 100 d by s. L is equal to 100 d by s plus d square upon 2. Again, here you are writing 100 d by s. Okay. So the expression of AB will become AB is equal to 100 d by s plus ds upon 200. Okay. Now, we know that W is a width that is available for cultivation. So not this entire L length is available, only this W is available for cultivation. Okay. So width that is available for cultivation, that is W, that is given by, that can be calculated as D, W plus D. Sorry. W is a width that is available for cultivation after terracing. So W is a width that is after terracing. Actually, there is a diagram I need to improve. So W is equal to D. So W plus D is equal to L. So L is equal to W plus D, which is given by 100 D by S. And W, we can substitute the values here. We can write W is equal to 100 D by S minus D. So expression for W will become like this. Is equal to 100 d minus ds upon s. So the width that is not available for cultivation after terracing can be calculated as a ab. So this ab, this length is reduced. So ab minus this w, ab minus w. So for example, this is actually your ab. And this is actually your w. Okay. So length that is not available for cultivation will be equal to AB minus W. Okay. So we write this expression like this. So we know AB, value of AB minus W. Okay. So this width that is not available for cultivation will be given by DS upon 200 plus DS plus S. Okay. Now the width lost in percentage of original inclined width. Okay, so original inclined width, that is AB. So AB value is given here. This is your AB. That is your 100 d by s plus ds upon 200. That is actually coming to denominator. And now width loss that we have just calculated here. So this is actually your width loss. So this divided by this will give us the percentage width, width lost in percentage width loss as compared to the original original length AB. Okay. So by substituting all this value, we can arrive at this equation. We can say that AB width loss in percentage of original inclined width AB is given as S plus 200. Into s by 20,000 plus s square into 100. We can arrange this equation like this. So this will give us the width lost in percentage of original width, which is given by s plus 200 divided by 200 by s plus s by 200. Okay. So right now we are talking about in terms of width, but in terms of area also it will be same, because only the because the length of the terrace will not play an important role. So length of terrace will not be affected by the reduction of slope. So that's why we can write this expression as percentage area lost. Y is equal to this expression. Percentage of area lost because of the bench terracing. Okay. Now let's see one example here. In this example, what is given to us that, or let's say this is a very straightforward example. You can go through this example. Okay, let's see this example. Or maybe this example. So in this example, what is given that region is hilly region. In a hilly region, bench terracing is proposed for cultivation purpose. For cultivation purpose, bench terracing is proposed. So the land is having 30% slope. So slope, the S is actually your 30%. Average soil depth that is given is around 1 meter. Limiting to the depth of cut is 0.7 meter. So depth of cut that is possible D by 2 is around 0.7 meter. Okay, riser to be laid at 1:1. So riser slope is also mentioned 1:1. So using that, we have to compute following thing. First, the width of terrace and earthwork per hectare and the cost of the terracing. If the cost of terracing is given as 2.5 rupees per meter cube of earthwork. So we have to calculate the earthwork per hectare and width of the terrace. Okay, so what is given to us that we have just seen? So this land slope is given, that is 30%. Soil depth is given as 1 meter. Depth of cut, that is permeable, that is given as 0.7 meter. Riser slope is 1:1 meter. And that can, using that actually we have to find out this thing. Okay, so since 1:1 slope is given and we have seen the expression for this one. So we can, when 1:1 slope is there, we can write this expression D by 2 upon D by 2 plus W by 2 that we have just a few slides back we have seen. For when the better slope is 1:1, this expression D by 2 upon D by 2 plus W by 2 is equal to S by 100, where D is actually your vertical interval, D by 2 is actually your depth of cut, W is actually your width of cut, total width of the bench, and S is actually your slope of the original slope of the land. Okay, so using that, D is equal to this expression we have seen, D is equal to, that is vertical interval is equal to WS upon 100 minus S. Width can be calculated by this one. W is equal to, rearranging this equation, we can write W is equal to D into 100 minus S upon S. Now, what is given to us? D by 2 is given. S is also given. Okay, substituting this value, we can calculate the value of width. So, W is equal to, D by 2 is given 0.7, so D will be 1.4. S is given 30%. So, we can write S is equal to 30 here. We can have, and using that, we can have W is equal to 3.27. So that is the first part of your answer. Now for the second part, we have to find the earthwork required. So we have seen how to estimate earthwork. We have to find out the area of the triangle. The area of the triangle can be calculated using this expression dW by A. That also we have seen, multiplied by length per hectare. Okay. So dW by A. So D is known. W is also known to us. W just we have calculated, using that we can estimate. Okay, so but before that, okay, so you can write this expression length per hectare. So this is your length per hectare. So that also we have seen, length per hectare can be calculated for 1:1 slope like this. So for 1:1 slope, vertical interval is given by this expression. Okay, so we can estimate this expression. Value of this one. So this expression will become 1250. This is the value of D that we have just substituted from here. 1250 into WS upon 100 minus S. So W is just we have calculated, S is known to us. Using that, we can calculate the earthwork required. Okay. So substituting the value, W just now we have calculated 3.27. S is given as 30%. Okay, so substitute this value, we'll get 1752 meter cube. Now we have to estimate the earthwork in terms of rupees. Okay, earthwork per hectare. That is the earthwork per hectare. Okay, now also we have to estimate the cost. So this is a per meter cube. So we have to just multiply with the 2.5. So this is actually your multiplied by 2.5 rupees per meter cube. It will be having 4380 rupees of earthwork, cost of earthwork. Okay, so quickly let's see one more column. That actually here actually what we have to do, we have to design a bench terrace for an area which has a specific type of soil. Specific type of soil means sandy soil is given, sandy loam soil is given, and the land slope that is given to us, that is actually 15%. So S is given, type of soil is given, sandy loam soil, and terrace width X as a channel. So means we have to provide some grade. And that grade can be also given uniform grade. Okay, so along that terrace, uniform grade is given, which is around 0.4%. So that is also given. So other details are given to us, the maximum rainfall intensity of the area for 10 years return period, 25 centimeter per hour for a duration equal to time of concentration that will be needed for estimating the peak discharge. Okay, and total length of bench terrace is given as 150 meter. L is given 150 meter. And we have to assume certain things to design this terrace. Now, first see what is given to us. So first, what is given to us? Type of soil is given, sandy loam soil given, and land slope S is given as 15%. Okay. Channel grade, we have to provide for 150 meter is actually your length of terrace. So we have to provide uniform grade of 0.4%. Okay. And maximum rainfall intensity is also given to us, 25 centimeter per hour. Okay. So using that, let's assume something. So for this kind of, so you can see the rainfall intensity is high. So you can think of inward sloping bench terrace. Inward sloping means this is inward sloping bench terrace. Okay. So we can think of this 5% slope here. We can assume this 5% inward slope here. And the width of the terrace we can assume as W is equal to 6%, 6 meter for 15% of the slope, and better slope as 1:1. This 1:1 we can assume. Okay. So using this, let's calculate different quantities. Okay. Now the area of the terrace. Area of the terrace can be width multiplied by the length. So width we have just assumed that is 6 meter, and length is given to us 150 meter. So L multiplied by W. If you want to calculate in terms of per hectare, so divided by 10,000 meter square. Okay, so that will give you the this is actually your meter square. So that is actually L is given in the question 156. We assume where we assume per hectare, so this will be given 0.09 hectare. Okay, so this will now our area of the catchment. So we can think of this as a catchment area. 0.09 hectare. Okay, now to calculate the peak discharge, we can use the rational formula. Qp is equal to CIA. Okay, where C we have to assume. So let's say we assume C is equal to 0.3 because for this kind of condition, if it is not given, you can assume 0.3 or any value. Okay, so C we assume 0.3. I that is given to us 25 centimeter per hour, and A just now we have calculated. So substituting this value, we can calculate QP peak discharge is equal to 0.01875. So our bench terrace or our channel should handle, means we are handling this much amount of discharge, peak discharge 0.01875 meter cube. Okay. So now we have calculated peak discharge. Now let's calculate other thing. Now coming to the cross section, let's assume a bund which is of base 0.75 meter. So base of this bund is actually 0.75 meter, and slope is around 2:1. This 2:1. Okay, and the depth of channel let's assume as 0.3 meter. So this is actually your 0.3 meter. So what we are doing, actually we are choosing various combination of depth. And whichever combination is giving us the proper value, that can be selected. So let's assume depth of channel is 0.3 and shoulder band 0.75. Using that, let's calculate this area of this channel. So area of this channel can be calculated by dividing into two parts. This is one part, this is another part. So this is one triangle. This is another triangle. So just calculate the area and add these two areas. So this area will be, so ADB will be given as half base into height. So half base, since the slope is 1:1, since this is 0.3, this will be also 0.3. half 0.3 into 0.3, and this is actually your now the total width of the terrace is given as 6 meter, and we have out of which we have provided 0.75 meter of shoulder bund. So this will be around 5.25 meter. So width base of this triangle will become 5.25, and height we have just assumed 0.3 meter. So half base into height, half base into height will be the area of this triangle. Okay, so total area of this triangle ABC will be given as sum of these two will be approximately 0.84 meter square. So now we have just calculated the area of the channel through which the flow will take place. Now we have to calculate the whether the flow velocity which is actually in the permissible limit or not, whether it is non-aversive or not. Okay, so before that we have to, so to calculate velocity we have to use this Manning's formula V is equal to RS 2 by 3 SS to 1 half upon N. N can be considered N is equal to 0.04, but the other two parameters we have to calculate. The R. R is actually your hydraulic radius that is given by A by P. So A we have just calculated in the previous slide, area, cross section area. P we have to calculate, that is the weighted parameter. So AB plus BC, that is actually your P. So we can calculate because these things are given. So we can calculate the weighted parameter. Weighted parameter is around 5.68. Area we have just calculated 0.84. So R will be equal to A by P, which is equal to 0.15 meter. S is also known to us. S is actually that is known. This S is not the land slope. This is actually slope of this channel. So because we are talking about this channel now. Okay, so slope of this channel. We are providing uniform slope, that is around 0.4%, means 0.004. So substituting this value, we will get the value of V is equal to 0.45. So this is not 0.6, this is less than 0.6. 0.6 is greater than 0.45, so we can consider this velocity as a design velocity. Okay, but that does not mean that our other assumptions are right or correct or not. For that, we have to do some more calculation. So we have to calculate the Q. So Q can be calculated as a using continuity equation, Q is equal to AV. So V we have just calculated as 0.45, and cross section area we have just calculated as 0.84. So using this, we can get Q is equal to 0.378. Now, before that, in earlier we have just calculated this thing. When we have used rational formula to calculate the peak discharge, so we have found the value of peak discharge is equal to 0.01875 meter cube per second. That was our peak discharge. Okay, but now what the discharge that we are getting here, that is around 0.378. So this 0.378 is actually much larger than our required capacity. Okay, so whatever the design we are doing, actually that can easily pass that thing. So we can go with this design, or we can modify the design by choosing a different depth and different combination of riser slope and other dimension. Okay. So this is how we can solve this problem. Okay. So other problems, I have some examples I have given to you in the slides. You can, these are straightforward problems that you can check. So with that, we'll end this module here, which was design of terrace. And from the next class, actually, we'll start the new module that is actually the gully control structures. Okay. So with that, we'll stop here for today. Okay. And I have shared one link with you on your Moodle page. So this was regarding the IS code assignment. So the group leaders are supposed to fill those forms, and they have to mention their suitable dates, suitable time slot when they are available for presentation of the assignment too. Okay. So with that, we'll stop here. If you have any question, you can email me, or you can ask me right now, or you can just ask that question on